It looks kind of organic, doesn't it?
Hey, what's up guys? I hope you're feeling hungry today because in this video, we're making pancakes. Degassified pancakes. Now, over the last couple of months, I've literally seen hundreds and hundreds of requests of people asking me to take pancake mix and put it in the vacuum chamber. What kind of pancakes would you make if you sucked all the air bubbles out of them? So I randomly pulled out a comment from Ramil Kasim who says, Grant, you have to make a pancake batter, then take out all the bubbles, then cook it. It should turn out to be really satisfying. Well, Ramil, that's what we're putting to the test today so we can find out just how satisfying degassified pancake mix really is. Now, for this experiment today, I went down to the local grocery store and picked up a box of this instant pancake mix. I also got a couple of eggs, some pancake syrup, as well as some milk and some vegetable oil. So to get started, I think we're just gonna flip this box over and follow the recipe on the back to make a batch of classic pancakes. Interesting side note, these eggs are from our chickens. Look at those rich orange yolks. So here we are guys, I just went ahead and blended up all the ingredients as per the instructions and this is what we've got. A nice beautiful batch of pancake mix that should make anywhere from 10 to 14 pancakes. And I even brought up the mixer just to pump a little extra air into it as well. You can see I've divided the batter into two different batches here. One of them is gonna get poured on regularly to make normal pancakes. The other one, we're gonna stick down to the vacuum chamber and suck all the bubbles out. All right, here we go. Vacuum chamber versus pancake mix in 3, 2, 1. There are a lot of air bubbles in there. Just keeps going. Now this stuff is resilient. Just won't give up, it just keeps going and going. I'm like on my 30th cycle here and it's still going strong. But I think we're about to defeat it. It's on its last legs here. All those air bubbles coming up out of the bottom, sucking them out slowly, cycling the process. I think we're almost at the end. Maybe another 15 or 20 cycles. Yeah, there it is, there it is. This is where we get all the air out. It looks kind of organic, doesn't it? In fact, watch this, if I turn off the vacuum pump, oh, that was cool. Yeah, it looks like it's alive. Now we're gonna leave this thing running for a few more minutes, and while we're waiting, let's go ahead and make a regular batch of pancakes so at least we can get those on the menu. Looking hot, hot, hot. Ooh, that is pretty hot. Maybe too hot? I don't know, let's find out. Here we go, pancake number one. Now the box says cook until the edges are dry and then turn and cook until golden. So that's what we're gonna do. Following the directions, folks. And the edges look fairly dry there. Let's go ahead and give it a flip. Oh, I burned it. Must have been too hot. We'll need to feed that to the chickens. That cooked a little bit faster than I was expecting. Let's go with pancake number two. That should be good. Okay, I'm not gonna burn this one. Ooh, bullseye. Listen to that sizzle. Ooh, and you see all the bubbles rising here? Pretty sure we're not gonna have that with the vacuum chambered version. Ooh, very nice. Getting better. It's crazy, this stuff is still going. It's been running for like, I don't know, 6, 7 minutes, and it's still bubbling. What the heck?
Oh, fail. That was bound to happen. Woo, doggy. All right. Our first batch of pancakes is done. Voila. Ooh, Grant, the chef in training, has just made pancakes, and this is what we've got. This is our regular batch, and looking at them, you can see they look just like regular pancakes. Fluffy, golden brown. Let's be honest, guys, I really don't know how to cook food in the kitchen. It's not what I do. Chemicals and experiments, yes. Food, not so much. Bon appetit, baby. All right, so they passed the test. I'm not a cook, but those definitely are pancakes. Now let's try the version from the vacuum chamber. We've had this thing sitting in here for about 10 minutes. Let's go ahead and release the pressure. There we go. And I'm gonna make this transfer really quick here because I think there's a reaction taking place, maybe with the baking soda and the water, to produce the bubbles itself. So the faster we can get these things in the frying pan, the less bubbles will appear in our solution. That one seems to be a little flatter. I mean, just looking at it from the side. Not making any judgments yet, just looking for observations. Whoa, where'd that bubble come from? There's actually bubbles coming up in the pancake. Could it be from the water turning into steam? Because after 10 minutes in the vacuum chamber, there theoretically shouldn't be any bubbles, right? But that right there, that's quite a few bubbles. I mean, that is actually a lot of bubbles. It's like a bad breakout of acne. You can see the comments loading up, Trypophobia! I'm just gonna let that cook a little bit longer because that's a really interesting pattern. Man, that looks so crazy. I actually don't want to flip it over because that's looking really cool. It's like honeycomb, but scary. Kind of looks like those little holes you get from mango worms. I have to say, that right there was a very unexpected result. Huh. Yep, pretty sure I burned the heck out of the bottom there. But look at that. The whole thing turned to bubbles. Where'd those bubbles come from, guys? It didn't come from my batter. I took all the bubbles out of the batter. Yep, the bubbles are coming already. Look at that. What the heck? If I don't flip it over right away, it starts bubbling up like crazy. I mean, look at those things. What the heck? That's crazy. They're like English crumpets or something. How's it taste? It tastes very dense. It's not light and fluffy like a pancake. It tastes almost rubbery. Kind of tastes like chewing on a hardened slime, if you can imagine that. Appetizing, right? So these results were completely unexpected. First of all, these are the pancakes that we made normally. These are normal pancakes. Pancake mix from the vacuum chamber, on the other hand, makes something that looks completely different. How bizarre. Look at these things. These are completely different. And what's really interesting is even though we sucked out all the air bubbles, these ones are pocked with bubbles. Look at that. Looks like some kind of beehive honeycomb. That's crazy. Look at that. You know what's kind of cool about this design though? All those little holes will catch more syrup. So you could really load these suckers up. Look at the way the syrup just soaks right down into all those little bubbles. Taste test. Firm, a little bit crunchy, lots of syrup, lots of flavor. Definitely not bad. I mean, they're not pancakes, but they're not bad. Vacuum chambered pancakes, they're now a thing. So guys, today we set out on a mission to find out what would happen if you tried throwing pancake mix in a vacuum chamber and sucking out all the bubbles. Would you make pancakes without bubbles? The answers that came in response to our experiments were very, very surprising. We ended up with pancakes with more bubbles. Both pancakes look relatively the same on one side, but you flip them over and they look absolutely different. And in a weird way, I kind of feel like we invented some new kind of organic species. I mean, it's delicious, but it's creepy. The batter that made these pancakes sat in a vacuum chamber for over 10 minutes extracting all the gas. So why on earth did our pancakes come out looking like this? If you have any theories on why bubble-free pancake mix produced pancakes with bubbles, put your thoughts in the comments below. Just for fun, let's go ahead and rip one of these things in half and take a look at the cross section. Oh, wild, look at that. It almost looks like the spores of a mushroom. Mushroom pancakes, ugh. That's crazy, look at that.
They just like streak up. It makes such an interesting looking texture. Let's rip the top off. You can see all these bubble layers at the bottom. Definitely crustier at the bottom, but it's still very firm material all the way through.
So there you have it, guys. Using a vacuum chamber and some pancake mix from the grocery store, we've managed to make ourselves some of the most bizarre looking pancakes I've ever seen in my life. I mean, those really are just really odd looking. And a big thanks to Ramil Kasim for being one of the many people requesting this experiment. You can go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, Ramil. I'm sending you 25 bucks. Hey, thanks for joining me for this experiment. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then.
I keep spilling.